Dear students, welcome to our class on practicals on air temperature. So before we go into the class, I would like to impress upon you that as far as temperature is concerned, theory is available in my YouTube channel, Agrometeorology, Farms and Rural Development. Even what I sincerely request you is download the practicals on air temperature on your most safe place, at your most safer place. Why? Because most of the places there is an internet problem. So before we go into the class, a quote to inspire you: no one is paid for what they know. K-N-O-W, no. No one is paid for what they know. They are paid for only what they do. That is the performance. They are paid for what they do actually. No, K-N-O-W, no. L-E-D-G-E, if you add knowledge, no knowledge. So no one pays for knowledge. Where and how they pay? Because of your performance. No one is paid for what they know. They are paid for what they do. That is the performance. Now, so with this small quote, so let us go into our class. The measurement of air temperature. Air temperature. Temperature is the dominant factor controlling the rate at which a crop develops. So in the theory class, as I said, Agrometeorology, Farmers and Rural Development is my YouTube channel. There I have given clear information basics. As of now, advances I am going to give in the test group for PG and PhD level. But as for the basics is concerned, I have already provided what is the importance of temperature. Now, so there are different instruments to measure the standard air temperature. Different types of thermometers used in agrometeorological research are based on different variables. That means, you know, thermometers, what you see when you go to a doctor, okay, he keeps one thermometer, okay. Yeah, okay, same. Almost similar thermometers are used for measuring the air temperature in the agrometeorological hub. There are the, based on the principles of how displacement, mercury in glass, alcohol in glass, mercury in steel, biometric thermometers, pressure-based. Pressure thermometers are there, resistance change, resistance thermometers are there, voltage, thermocouple, thermopiles, thermistors like that. So radiation, infrared thermometers are there. So that means temperature can be measured by using different instruments. We have having different principles. So now in this class, we are going to understand what is the maximum thermometer, what is the minimum thermometer, what is the dry bulb thermometer, what is the wet bulb thermometer, what is the thermograph. That we try to understand. And again, I am telling you, in a separate video of a very small duration, all these thermometers are in live. That I am going to record, that you see it separately. But as I told, please download this, okay, so that you know you can understand very clearly what are all these thermometers. Now, so maximum thermometer, the principle involved: expansion of mercury occurs due to change in the air temperature, which is measured by observing the height of the mercury column in the bore. This is the bore. There is a mercury. Okay, this is how the maximum thermometer expansion of mercury occurs due to change in the air temperature, which is measured by observing, just we observe it by the height of the mercury column in the bore or capillary of the thermometer. Presume that this is a thermometer. There is a mercury column visible. How the mercury is there? Where the mercury column has gone? That is the temperature. That is the maximum temperature. Simple. What is the operational measurement? Maximum thermometer is the highest temperature reached. It measures the highest temperature reached during a particular time in a day, usually around 215-230 in India. Okay, it occurs in the tropical areas usually. Okay, even though it may be obtained by observing the thermograph. Thermograph is another instrument where it goes on recording. However, where thermograph facilities are not there, the maximum thermometer helps us to record the maximum temperature reached during the day, which you will always see in the newspapers. Okay, so that's what. Now, so okay, where the self-recording thermograph facility is not there, maximum thermometer is useful. Now, so how it looks, you please see it there. The maximum thermometer is given. So there is a okay, constriction here. So there is a mercury, there is a constriction here. So you may be asked to draw a neat labeled diagram of a maximum thermometer and minimum thermometer also. Okay, maximum thermometer, we have got the mercury. Minimum thermometer, there is an alcohol. In a maximum thermometer, you have a constriction, a There is a point where constriction is there, small, narrow space. That I am going to tell you within one few seconds, 5 seconds. Minimum thermometer, there is an alcohol, there is a index, okay, metal index is there in the minimum, but you see it there. So how the maximum thermometer works? We presume that this is a maximum thermometer. The simplest maximum thermometer is a mercury in glass thermometer. It is a mercury in glass thermometer, not alcohol in glass. Alcohol in glass is the minimum thermometer. Okay, now, so the bore in the stem of this thermometer is made extremely fine, okay, near the neck of the bulb. Presume that this is the bulb. There is a bulb here. Here, there is a small neck here. The presence of this constriction, this we call it the constriction, okay, the presence of this constriction is of such a size that it only allows the expanding mercury to pass as the temperature rises at 6 o'clock, 7 o'clock, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 1, 1, 15, okay, 1, 30, 1, 45, 2, 2, 15. It allows which one? From the bulb, there is a small narrow constriction, it allows, okay, mercury breaks at the constriction, leaving a path in the bore. Why? After 215 or 230, the temperature of the air reduces. When the temperature of air decreases, start decreasing. Here, there is a break in the constriction. Why? Because here, the mercury column is thick, it is small. The thicker, the thinnest point is there in the constriction. So, it responds quickly to changes or decrease in the temperature of 230 in Indian conditions. Mercury goes, but up to 215 or 220 maximum. Okay, there is a maximum temperature recorded on the day. After 230, 245, 315, what happens? So this mercury won't come down. Why? Because there is a break in the constriction. C-O-N-S-T-R-I-C-T-I-O-N. Constriction is a narrow passage. Because it is a narrow passage, but the decrease in the temperature, it responds quickly, and there is a break in the column of the mercury. Because when temperature falls in the constriction, there is a break. Now, the mercury in the bulb can then contract while the mercury column remains above the constriction. This is the mercury. It breaks when the temperature falls. So, it is as it is. So, the length of the mercury column in the bore does provide the maximum temperature reached since the thermometer was the last set morning, okay, in the exercise on the establishment of a standard meteorological observatory. We understood which instrument should be measured at what time. In the morning, it is set, okay, continuous flow of the mercury will be there. Now, so, after it reaches the maximum, it stops there because there is a break in the constriction level for the mercury column, break is there. Now, this thermometer is mounted on a special support so that it can be released, okay, and tuned to the vertical position. Okay, usually, okay, we keep it like that. This can be reset by whirling the thermometer rapidly in the horizontal direction so that the detached thread of the mercury comes down past the constriction into the bulb. So, repeat the swinging in the next day. Okay, after we take out, till the thermometer reaches the same value as that of the dry bulb temperature. Okay, this should be read to the nearest tenth of a degree after each observation. The maximum thermometer has to be reset and kept ready for the next observation. Simple, very, very simple. In the morning, we keep the thermometer like this. Okay, in the stimulus state, okay, it is there. As the temperature increases 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 1, 1, 15, 1, 30, 1, 45, 2, 2, 15, the temperature goes on increasing, mercury goes. There is a constriction here between the bulb and the bore. Okay, this is the bore. Okay, right. So, in the constriction, there is a break when temperature falls. So that this mercury won't come. Next day, when the observer goes, he sees, he records the maximum. So this is the maximum thermometer. What is the minimum temperature? Minimum thermometer. Simple. Instead of mercury, there is alcohol. Okay. Methyl alcohol, the colorless alcohol, that is very important. Now, so expansion or contraction of alcohol in the bore is the bore of the thermometer, which occur due to changes in the air temperature as recorded by an index. Here, constriction break allows the mercury. Mercury measures here, separate index in the diagram, you know, index I have given, small metal index is there. Now, dumbbell shaped indicator, otherwise, you know, when we go for exercises, dumbbell, you know, like dumbbell shaped indicator will be in the alcohol. Now, what is the operation measurement? The minimum temperature is the lowest air temperature recorded during a day or for a fixed time. This may be obtained from the thermograph readings also. Minimum temperature thermograph, which I am going to tell you after a minute from now. So, okay. However, minimum thermometer provides a record of the lowest temperature occurring at a place of exposure from the time of setting until it is read, where thermograph facility is not there. Where thermograph facility is not there, the minimum temperature will record you by using the minimum thermometer. Minimum thermometer is the alcohol in bore. Okay. Mercury in bore is the magnetothermometer. Please note. Now, what is the operation measurement? This is an instrument used to measure the minimum temperature of the day. This has a large bore. It is a bore. Okay, it is a large bore. The bulb is there, bore is there. Now, it has a large bore and its fluid is colorless ethyl alcohol or alcohol. Just alcohol. Colorless. Not mercury. Here is the alcohol. There is a dumbbell shaped indicator. Now, within this liquid, in the bore of the tube, a tiny dark dumbbell shape, for the exercises we use dumbbells, like that shape, a metal index is there. Okay, shape index made up of a metal is present when the temperature decreases. How the temperature decreases, I told you in the theory. Please go to theory class. 6, 7, usually in the tropical areas, particularly in India, 6, 7 in the morning, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 1, 1:15, 1:15, 1:30, 1:45, 2, 2:15, 2:30, temperature goes on increasing. Okay? After 2:30, it goes on 2:45, 3 like that. You know? So it starts falling. See, 4, 5, 6, 7 in the evening, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, midnight, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 5:45, 6, just before the sunrise. So it goes on falling. That is how, okay, when the temperature falls, it is for more time in the tropical areas. Now what happens when the temperature decreases like this, after 2:15 up to sunrise next day, full light, and temperature goes on decreasing, evening goes on decreasing, night goes on decreasing. When the temperature decreases, the liquid contracts, the alcohol contracts with the decreasing temperature, the meniscus of the liquid pulls the index down to the surface. Okay, due to the surface tension, the meniscus alcohol has the surface tension. Due to surface tension of the alcohol, it brings down the dumbbell shaped indicator. From when 2:30, 3, 4, 5, 6 in the evening, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 1 in the morning, okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, up to that point it comes down. When the temperature rises again, when after 6 o'clock, 6:15, 6:30, 6:45, 7, when the temperature rises again, leaving the dumbbell shaped indicator, the alcohol column will go because the surface tension cannot carry, okay, the dumbbell shaped metal indicator. So when the temperature rises again, the alcohol flows around the index. It flows around the index. The meniscus moves up the bore. However, it leaves the index behind at the lowest point, to which the liquid surface descends to register the lowest temperature reached during the day. Okay, the position of the end of the dumbbell shaped index farthest from the bulb. Okay, so that is the lowest temperature. What is the meaning of it? Okay, when the temperature started falling, okay, from 2:42 next morning 6 o'clock, the meniscus which has got surface tension will bring the dumbbell shaped indicator, leaves it. When the temperature is rising, so around that index it will go up, it cannot carry. So farthest from the bulb, this is the bulb, so the other end here, bottom side close to the bulb, farthest from the bulb, no dumbbell shaped indicator, the farthest, that is the minimum temperature recorded during the day. So at the same time, the alcohol surface also indicates the current air temperature. Usually alcohol temperature is equal to, okay, mercury in glass thermometer usually. So magnetothermometer, okay, like that it will be corrected. So the minimum thermometer should always be kept in the horizontal position, not in the vertical position. Otherwise, it is a vertical position. It should be kept horizontal because the metal indicator, the metal index will fall through the liquid to the bottom. So that's why it should be. Now, so after the readings are taken, we take a magnet, he keeps the dumbbell shape indicator to the meniscus level after taking the reading, so that it will be said for reuse actually. So in case of magnetothermometer, we go for whirling till the correction is made. Constriction break is there, no? We go for like this. Okay, we keep it like this and then we see it like this, right? Now, so this is how after setting the thermometer for the next reading, we do it. Now, what is the dry bulb thermometer? Simply, dry bulb thermometer is almost like maximum thermometer. Expansion or constriction of mercury, as per the changes in the air temperature are observed in the bore of the thermometer. This is an accurate ordinary mercury thermometer. This mercury is, of course, enclosed in a sealed glass tube. This has an uniform bore, and the bulb is there, bore is there. The expansion or constriction of mercury takes place as per the changes in the temperature. So this is graduated usually in the tropical areas, minus 10 to 50, plus 50 degrees centigrade. This instrument always record the current temperature. Whenever you want it to know, okay, you go to the Stevenson screen, single Stevenson screen or double Stevenson screen. Just go to the maximum thermometer. Dry bulb thermometer, then you get the current temperature. So what is the wet bulb thermometer? If a muslin cloth is attached to the dry bulb thermometer, it is a wet bulb thermometer. So muslin cloth, we add it, and then through a wick, you know, so we keep water here. Now again, I'm telling in the live video of temperature recording, you know, there I show you. Please see those records also. Study in the theory also. Now what is the wet bulb thermometer? The expansion and contraction of mercury take place as per the changes in the air temperature, like the maximum thermometer or dry bulb thermometer. Here also same. However, under the wet condition of the bulb made moist by muslin cloth. Here we just add the muslin cloth when atmosphere is saturated. So what is the temperature? This is shown by the wet bulb thermometer. Why this is useful? For recording the humidity, that I tell you, in the humidity, even in this class also. Now what is the operation measurement? This is also same as that of the dry bulb thermometer, but the bulb is covered with the muslin, just muslin cloth. Okay, muslin cloth is there. The bulb is continuously kept moist when the by using the muslin cloth. The other end of the cloth is dipped in a container with water, preferably distilled water. Evaporation from the muslin lowers the temperature of the bulb. Okay, why? Because the evaporation goes on occurring. Okay, it lowers the bulb. This will give when atmosphere is completely humid. So that's what. Now, so this thermometer indicates the temperature of the ambient air temperature under saturated conditions. Okay, assuming how the temperature would be under the saturated conditions, we know from this one the difference between the readings of the wet and dry bulb thermometers is called wet bulb depression. This bit will come both in the practice and theory. The difference between the maximum thermometer and minimum thermometer, dry bulb thermometer, wet bulb thermometer, we go on recording it. But the difference between the readings of wet and dry bulb thermometers is called as the wet bulb depression. Maximum thermometer is showing 35. Minimum thermometer is showing wet bulb thermometer is showing 25. The depression is 10 degrees. Okay, that's why. So from the readings of the dry bulb and wet bulb depression, the relative humidity as well as the vapor pressure can be found in the by using the calibrated tables. The relative humidity is always expressed as the percentage. Now, what is the thermograph? So let us sum it up simple. What is the dry bulb? What is the wet bulb? What is the maximum thermometer? What is the minimum thermometer? Simple. They are the very, very simple thermometers. So again, I am telling in the live video, so I show you once again. So let us go to thermograph. Here, the temperature is recorded. Okay. Graph means, you know, recorded. The permanent record is there. It is, you just, for every day, you keep on recording sheet. It records. It records maximum. It records minimum. However, where there is no facility of thermograph there, okay, maximum thermometer, minimum thermometer, dry bulb, wet bulb thermometers are useful. So it's a very simple thermometer. Thermograph is a very, very simple, very, very interesting. There are two dissimilar metals are there. This is a metal and this is a metal, for example. Okay, for example, this is a metal and this is a metal. These are two different metals having different coefficient of expansion. For the changes in the air temperature, this expands, this contracts, otherwise. Okay, one end of these are two metals, that's why we call it as the bimetal. One end we solder it, okay. The other end is attached to a magnifying system and a pen arm. That pen arm records the temperature continuously for the changes in the temperature. How? You just learn it. The principle, two metals having different coefficient of expansions like inward branch are welded together to form a sensitive element. This is the sensitive element. Sensitive element. This is the sensitive element. This is connected by a system of linkages to a pen. This is connected to a magnifying system and a pen. Okay. On a chart wrapped on a drum, which is operated by a clockwork. A drum is there, it is operated. Again, I am telling you in the live video, you see, after this I am uploading, there you see the live drum also. So what is operation measurement? This is a self-recording device. Self-recording, it goes just like our watch, you know, there is a rotating drum. Okay, so in gas, in the case of our self-recording rain gauge, okay, Simon's rain gauge, it gives only quantity. Self-recording rain gauge, like the same drum is here, clockwise drum. Now, so what is it? This is a self-recording device. This is used to obtain continuous and accurate record of air temperature. The sensitive element of this instrument is a bimetallic tip. Two metals are there. It is a solder. Okay, it is a coil. Two metals, they are made into a coil-like. Coil-like. Two metals, coil-like. Okay, so one end of this instrument is fixed and the other end is a delicate set of lever mechanism. A delicate set of lever mechanism. This is soldered and a delicate set of lever mechanism. This is a coil. Lever mechanism is there. To this there is a pen. So this is how. Okay, you can see it there. So bimetallic chip is there on the right side. So it is attached to lever mechanism, magnifying mechanism. There is a rotating drum. That rotating drum makes rotation like our watch. Okay, like watch, it goes on recording. Now, the tip of the arm is self-inked for the pen. The tip of the arm is self-inked and touches the calibrated chart wrapped around the rotating drum. There is a rotating drum, there is a chart. Okay, so on that, we keep the pen. The drum completes one rotation in a day of 24 hours and works on the clock mechanism when the temperature changes. Okay, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, the temperature goes on increasing. 2, 230, 215, okay, maximum. Again, it falls. It goes on recording on the rotating drum. Okay, so these changes are recorded on the calibrated chart. X-axis we have got, Y-axis we have got. So the X-axis of the chart represents the time, Y-axis represents the temperature. The chart has to be refreshed every day. Now, so units of measurement, degree centigrade, degree Fahrenheit, that I have already told in the theory class. Now, a small exercise you can plan. Of course, how you can plan to measure the air temperature at different sites and also to find whether there is any difference in air temperature at different levels in a crop canopy. So we are agrometeorologists. We should devise an experiment. How we can devise an experiment? We can take a small experiment I planned. Please do this one. Relevant information, okay, that I have given already in the theory. Now let us go. What is the materials that are required? Dipole thermometers, 7. Stevenson screen boxes are insulating metal shields, 7. Clock watches, 2. Tables are supporting stands, 6. Graph sheets, 2 numbers and 1 pencil. You take. First you take all these things. Then what you do? Mount the dry bulb thermometers vertically in the Stevenson screen, metal shields as seen in the observatories. Take 4 thermometers, okay, and keep one each on tables in a practical class room where our practical class is going on. There you keep one. In the open field, you keep one. Open field, you know, that doesn't mean that, you know, you should allow the thermometer, okay, to the sun. Open field means, you know, with a shield, you can keep it there. Under the shade of a tree, you keep one. And near a water surface, maybe a bucket of water you take, there you keep one. All at 4 feet. The uniform height should be 4 feet away from the ground. That should be the case. Take 4 thermometers, place them in 4 different locations, 4 feet away from the surface of the earth. In our classroom, one like that. Okay. So record 5 to 6 readings at 15 minutes interval. So 4 different locations you have kept 4 thermometers. Okay. So you go on recording for every 15 minutes. How in these 4 locations the temperature is changing, you can record it. Plot a graph, make some readings. This is how. So in the, I have given a recording sheet also. In the recording sheet, you do it, you get good knowledge. measurement of air temperature at different levels and crop canopy. Crop canopy means, you know, in a near crop also, measurement of air temperature at different sites, 4 feet higher above the ground. Okay, like that, you know, so you can plan your experiments depending upon the instruments available. This is what I would like to say before I say thanks to you. So we have discussed in the class what is maximum thermometer, minimum thermometer, dry bulb, wet bulb, thermograph, and how to do a practical for agrometrology. Okay, that also. So before I end, once again, the quote of our class: no one is paid for what they know. Knowledge, KNOWLEDGE. They are paid for what they do, what they perform. Okay, thank you very much. May God bless you. Please download in a safe place. Keep it safe. Study well. May God bless you.